This is the plant that we can't seem to get a full day running out of since we set it up. That's Tony's feeder I'm leasing from. It's heap. So we've had to do a load of modifications and work on it. These conveyors, they're cheap.
You got spare belts and stuff and all that?
I got a spare belt coming because this one's trashed.
This plant isn't really set up for this kind of ground. We've got big boulders, a lot of rocks, and it's just hard on everything. It's going to need a bunch of modifications to make it hold up to running this kind of material. But this is what he has, so we'll just have to work with what we have, make it work.
It's good to see everything working, and maybe today's when things start looking up, and hopefully we can have our luck turn around a little bit.
Joke.
The conveyor that runs dirt from the feeder to the plant is shredded.
Man, are you kidding me?
Jesus.
What are we gonna do now? I don't have a belt for this thing.
Yeah, not putting that back together.
Just pieces left now, man. She's toast.
Sick.
It never ends. It never ends.
Well, we can't shut down and wait for a belt.
What are you thinking then?
I don't know. What do you think, Gene?
Well, I think we just take the feeder from there and build a pad and move it up into here where this was at.
Move the whole feeder up to the plant?
Yeah, just raise the pad up and make it work.
All right, let's get it done.
Gene's plan is brilliantly simple. Get rid of the entire broken conveyor. Replace it with a solid pad of coarse tailings. And move the 12.5-ton hopper feeder onto the pad. So they can feed pay dirt straight into Monster Red.
Alignment looks good. Try that. Ooh-wee. Good work, guys. Let's get sluicing.
Let's get to work.
Start it up.
In less than 3 hours, Gene has Rick's operation back up and running.